Welcome to Physical Science in the AM. That's my new song. I just made it up. So I actually had these up before the end of the class, but the idea is to be able to balance an equation. Use that equation to take given information and change chemicals using the balancing numbers from the reaction. Right? Are we getting this? Like, this is where you don't know. This is a perfect time to say, don't get it. And don't ever feel awkward about that. If you can't do it in front of people, talk to me. Sometimes just once you get going on something, talk about it. Okay. I forget. I think I might have shown this one. Maybe not. Anyways, I asked you to just come up with a reaction based on the words, right? These are skills, right, from the front of the unit. Now, this whole idea is being used here. We're combining the two skills from the sort of two subunits. Okay, the flow ratio, that's based on the reaction. Is this one going good? Now, when I show these, stuff like this, I'm marking this sentence. For the most part, 85%, 90% of you are doing really well at showing your work. I prefer these flat fractions so you can clearly show what crosses out and stuff like that, right? That's important. Here's why. If you wrote down something like 0.0, okay, whatever. You wrote down some number here that it was incorrect, but you had this set up right and was just some calculator mistake, I'll give you one out of two. If you write down very little without labels and stuff, you would get 0%. Sort of an insurance policy. And I need to know you know. That's the way. I can't tell what you're thinking unless you know. So I'm scrolling through these. I'm not getting anyone saying, wait a minute, how did this work? Because we're going to build on this. Yes. Oh, perfect. Hey, CL. I'm going to write this down. And okay, number five. This is what I was waiting for. Someone asked me for something. Calculate the number of moles of potassium chlorate, that must decompose. So I knew the word decompose means where it starts, it breaks apart. It tells me what it decomposes. If I didn't have decomposes it to produce HCl and oxygen. So we were told that. If you weren't told anything about what it decomposes to, you would just guess it's the three elements. Right? I didn't hear you back. But you were told that. And then you balance it. So, first part, five. Did that make sense to you? The reaction from words. And then balancing. Right? The word decomposition is from our first part of the unit. Then, let me see. Calculate the number of moles of potassium chloride, KCl3, when 1.80 moles of oxygen are in. So I start with the information that's given. Typically, you start with something that's not a fraction. The balanced reaction. Did I make a mistake on this? It's like, there he's asking. Nope. Okay, I was just thinking. No. Is there anything you want? Is there anything that you need? Like, does it make sense now? That's the important. Okay. here to make some mistakes. I'm going to just jot down that T as increments A 46.
Okay, so number six.
Calculate the number of moles of oxygen burned, 1.82. Then find the moles of nitrogen dioxide and water. So, it's sort of a three-part question without ABC. But the important thing isn't that you're jotting down the answers if you didn't do them. The important thing is if you're jotting down the answers, that at a later time you take the time to try those. I'm going to pause this video part because it's here for people who are watching.
Stoichiometry.
Once again, calculations this time involving mass to moles or moles to mass. So we went moles to moles always, right? Every problem said, you know, 1.2 moles react this, calculate the moles. Now we're going to have mass involved graphs. Okay? Mass is measured in grams. We don't use weight in chemistry. That's a subtle difference. It is important, but we're not getting into it. So let's take a look at this first example. Okay, I have a balanced reaction already. So I'm assuming you're not a balanced reaction. Okay. By the way, I put down solid and gas and solids. You don't have to every time. I'm just putting it there to get used to that. We have 22.66 grams of sodium are reacted with oxygen. How many moles of sodium oxide are produced? Now, I'm just mentioning because it's stuff we've learned about today, 10N now. I'm getting a mixture. Sometimes I'll get formulas. Those are pretty easy. Sodium oxide, I get as words. So hopefully you recognize that's sodium oxide. But prerequisite skills. Now, how do we go about doing this? We start with what we're given information. 22.66 grams of sodium. I'm going to write down 22.66 grams of sodium. Now, we are going to convert this to moles. Let me see what happens. We're going to continue on. This is going to be like a multi-step conversion. So I can't use the 4-to-1 or the 4-to-2 ratios and stuff like this. I guess it's sodium then. It's a 4-to-2 ratio with grams. It just doesn't double or halve like that. Have to get to moles if you don't have it already. The biggest problem is we always had moles, so we skip straight to the balance range. That moles is so good. This one's pretty easy. I got to get rid of grams, moles. I look it up on the periodic table. This one I use enough that I know it's 22.99. But I always second guess myself, so I take a look. 22.99. If I stopped calculating this mole, I would have moles of soda. Does that make sense? Yes, sure. It would be crazy. This is reinforcing what's coming up on Friday's quiz or later. Okay. I'm going to use a different color only just to emphasize. I'll stop here. Maybe I'll even write this down on here. Get moles of meat. Sometimes you start with moles. Right? After moles, though, we got to change the chemical. The balanced reaction. So we have sodium, but we want information about sodium oxide. So I know that core sodium produce a ratio of 4-to-2, so 2 sodium oxide. So I've gotten rid of information about sodium. If I stop right now, I have information about moles of sodium oxide. And I can stop. That's what I want. Moles of sodium oxide. So I need to calculate. By the way, if you recognize 2 to 4 ratio at 1 half, you can do that too. But put it in the calculator like this. 22.6 divided by 22.99 because it's on the bottom. Times 2, it's on the top, divided by 4. I think I did it correctly. If somebody wants to verify. But no, 4928. I'm going to model significant digits. I've got 4 and 4, so I'm going to have 4 in my answer. The balance numbers you consider 100% incorrect or not incorrect. So you don't use that to make those decisions. So I'm going to write down 4 digits, 0.49282, so I round off to 0.4. There's the number. We'd only get 0.5 on this answer. That's small. So, you're wondering why there's a star there. Just because of how it worked out. Pretty much the exact same thing. Convert to moles, very different things. But I found over the years that just because I haven't worked on things, people learn better if I ask them to do things. Any questions about this kind of thing? As you can guess, I have more. Very school teacher? I can go with it. Magnesium, what's nitrogen? Magnesium nitride. What's the mass of magnesium nitride produced for 22 moles of magnesium? This is the other way around. We start with moles. And we want grams, that's not. So I mean, normally the other one, I got moles with my first step. We have moles, so let's break that down. 22 moles. I don't need to write out the whole word, I'll just put that out. Magnesium, Mg. If I'm going to get rid of magnesium, I'll make sure that looks like a capital F. It's all there. And I want information about magnesium nitride. Now, according to this, I'm just double checking my balancing. Yep. So 1-3 ratio. If I stop right now, I would have moles of magnesium nitride. Yesterday, that would have probably been the question. Today, though, we want to go one step further. We have moles, we convert it to chemical, and we want to end up with mass. That's great. So I want to get rid of moles, and we're talking about magnesium nitride. One mole, and I got to add this up. I do need my calculator. Yes. Mg, 3, and 2. So I'm going to use the mass of 3 mg's, 3 mg's. 3 times 24. 31. Add it to 2 groups of 14.01. Mm. I'm double checking here because I'm 100.95 is what I get out of this. Okay, so put together all these skills. Balanced reactions, converting moles and grams, etc. Calculator entry time. 22 divided by 3 times 100. I get 740.3. I'm going to put that up top here. Now, I'm not going to write that as my final answer. I have 22.0. That's 3 significant digits. This is 5 significant digits. I'm going to go to the least amount. Where was it? 7. grams, I've gotten rid of mold. Magnesium nitrate. When you show your work, it's important to show your work. I'll just go through them. I give a mark for this step, a mark for this step, and a mark for an answer we can correct you. This last part, I'm just emphasizing that you've gotten rid of moles, you've gotten rid of vegetable things. I don't think just because you one example of each, starting with moles, starting with that, you've got it. So I'm going to give you more practice too, but let's just take a look at these together. Composition reaction again, that we did earlier, right? How many grams of? So I can ask for how, what's the mass of, or what, how many grams? Same thing. Potassium chloride must be composed to produce potassium chloride at 1.45 moles per oxygen. I can start with what the single item that we're getting, 1.45 moles of oxygen. Now, your first bracket, if you don't have moles, you get moles. What do we do? I got to change chemicals. I want to get rid of information about oxygen. Three groups of O2 from the balance reaction. I want the information about the potassium chloride. And if I stop now, I'm not going to. I have moles of potassium chloride. I'm not going to, because I was asking the client. So I want to get rid of moles, so I put that down 10. I know this is going to cancel. I'm going to add up the grams of K, a Cl, and 3 oxygen. Okay, 39.1 plus Cl, 35.41, plus 3 groups of oxygen, 3.6. 122.55. Anything you add up on the periodic table, keep it 2 dozen. 22.5. Okay. There. Now there's a hand in. Come over here. So, this is a calculator exercise now. 1.45 times 2 divided by 3 times 122.55. Double checking, I entered it correctly. I think so. 122.5. Yeah, okay. 118.465. More digits than we need. We need 3 digits because of the first, the red. 118.465 is 118.5 in the decimal board. So it's built. 180. This would be grams. This is KCl3, and that is what we were grams. That's important. Marks, you can see how that would work. Then, just this is finish off here. Using the same reaction. Find the mass of KCl, potassium chloride, produced. 8.21 grams of KCl3 are decomposed, so it's writing the gram information about the reactant. Okay, 8.21. Start with that. The lucky day. I already added up KCl3. You've got 122.55. Get rid of grams. Keep more. 122.5. Find the mass of KCl3. my graphs are, so I can't stop. I have graphs, right? Plot grid up. Now I have moles of potassium chloride, right? But chloride. I want to, potassium chloride 2, KCl 3. I wrote down, there's no way to do it. I said it wrong. Two groups, KCL. Caught myself. Now, if I stop now, I have moles of KCL. This one's actually an extra little step here. Find the mass of KCl. I only have the moles of KCl. Mass times grams. What do you think we do then? Yeah. This is an extra step. This is where we're going tomorrow. So I'm going to get rid of moles. This is KCl we're talking about. And add up K plus Cl. Let's see now. 34.55. I could put times 2 divided by 2 as far as the green step, but if you recognize that it just divides itself up. No, I should. Am I authorized to give lessons? What religion? I don't even know. I know, I should. Anyway, back to this. 8.21 times 1 divided by 122.5. Oh, I got it. I think I have to say that one. That's one. 8.2. Divide by a reactor. 122.5. Times 2 divided by 2. I'm not going to put in. Times 74. I get 4.99433. Okay, so I only need 3 digits. So 4.99. This is grams and KCl. The problems I'm going to give you though tend to be just start with moles, get grams, and grams start with moles. I'm going to give you this set of problems right, and I'll talk to you about how. See what I'm asking you to consider. This goes for every problem for the next little while, like week or so. First, make sure you have a balanced equation. This one happens to be balanced for you. But double check. Identify the materials you're working with. When I read here, I see, oh, moles of sugar are decomposed to give exactly 79 grams of carbon. Maybe you're not familiar with sugar for this first one. But usually I give enough information, I think you can figure this one out. Because I know this is carbon. I know this is water, so this has to be sugar. Right? Convert to moles, if you don't have them already. Well, this is grams of carbon, so I will start with 700 grams of C and then convert to moles. Set the ratio for your two substances. I've been showing that in the meeting yesterday, right? The balanced equation is the front end. Identify your own unknown. What are you trying to find? You might already have it solved there. Solve for your unknown. If you need to go further, an extra step with grams. And then that's basically it. Okay. So try these three problems. What else? Oh,